Hey, welcome everybody. Progressive Programming, Craig Howard here, and head coach and programmer Jamie Lee. We're here to talk to you about November's programming, which is a shock that we're already at November. First things first though, we're still deep in the open. Yep. We're recording this ahead of time before we release it. The open has been going fun. I will say, as an affiliate owner, the open is an important part of Diablo's business, primarily because no one else around us, and none of our competition, can offer the open, right? Yeah. Whether it's Orange Theory with other functional fitness gyms, F45, Roadhouse, no one else has got the open. So it makes it a really cool thing, a unique characteristic of CrossFit and of Diablo CrossFit. Mm-hmm. The other thing is for 5 weeks, it's a pain in the ass and it's a lot of work. It is. But we get our community together for 5 weeks on Friday nights. We get to intermingle with them. We get classes in the morning, intermingling with classes in the evening, so it helps build a better community. And one of the things that we do, and I encourage all other affiliates to do this, make sure you have a good photographer on hand. Because you take those pictures and your members will love getting them, and they redistribute them. We have had more people requesting startups and coming in and asking about being a part of Diablo. And I think it's directly attributable to the open and the activity of our members bragging about the results and then showing the pictures that we've taken of them. So quick tip for affiliate owners out there, embrace the open. Yes. It's work, but it's fun.
Totally, totally rewarding.
Yeah, but I do have a criticism for head coach Jamie Lee. He does our programming 2 months in advance, which we like, and we know our progressive programming customers like getting the programming in advance, but he seems to have predicted the open. A couple of the workouts at the day after or 2 days after were almost identical. Week one, bar facing burpees, ground overhead, I think showed up the next day in programming. Week two, what was week
double
two?
Unders and
that's right
double carry
and thrusters right, and then in week three heavy deadlifts, and then the very next day heavy deadlifts. And our members will ask, hey, why are you programming deadlifts? And I tell them, well, it's because we do our programming far in advance in preparation of putting them on, well, primarily to put them on a progression that will help them make results. And it's impossible to predict what Dave Castro is going to do with the open. What are your thoughts on this, on back-to-back programming when it happens like that? And what's your plans for next year?
So for this year, the idea was, you know, we want to program out, still maintain some kind of a strength progression, still maintain our, you know, workout of the day. But as we led in towards the open, we're focusing more on monostructural and like higher skill movements, but not a lot of volume, you know, something that's not going to have a huge impact on how we perform going into the open.
Yeah, I saw that the 10 by 300 meter row, for example, 250 for the ladies.
You know, even with the, you know, the bike run row every second, that's minute, minute, 30 minutes of cardio.
Yeah, those were great because there are members that want to come in every day and they'll come in the day before Friday night lights for us where we do the open workout and they want to work out, and that was a great way to keep them from blowing themselves up.
Yeah, and I mean, the other thing that we got to think of is, you know, the open is a competition, right? Yeah. And, you know, those that are participating and competing in the open need to respect it as, you know, a competition, and, you know, tailor your workout week to where, whether you're doing a Friday night lights or a main Saturday or a Sunday fun day, you're gonna take a day off before and maybe even after, depending on how the workout goes. So, you know, the fact that we had the heavy deadlift right after the deadlift workout, you know, I wonder how many people actually took a rest day and got better from that rest day. So it's kind of a way to kind of force rest during this hectic time of the year of 5 workouts a week.
I do know that I did see some people in on Saturday that had done Friday night lights, but they were substituting, you know, our coaches recommended people not do deadlifts.
Yes.
They do a different movement and or go really light and just work on technique and try and loosen things up. And again, that's where it's incumbent upon coaches to make sure they're aware of what their athletes are doing.
So. And so for next year, I still will continue with that same format, you know, working with a monostructural, but what we'll have also is a second track. We'll call it the open track, which will, you know, be determined on what the workout is. You know, how is the next few days going to look after the open workout? So if you want to implement the open into your programming for your gym, this would be a great option.
Oh, that's good. Yeah, that'll work good. Great. Let's talk about November. In in October. We're coming off back squat. Now we're moving into primary strength is front squat.
Front squat.
Well, tempo front squat.
Yes, not just the front squat.
Right.
So as we go into the front squat, we're going to be focusing on a tempo. Beginning of the month, we're going to have more reps working into a 3 second count, 2 second hold at the bottom, and then a one second driving out. What we want to focus on is maintaining position and control, not just through the squat, but also through our trunk and our midline. So breathing is going to be a really big part of it. Make sure you're not holding your breath through the entire set. It's a good way to give yourself a little lightheadedness. But we'll be finishing off the month of November with a front squat, one rep max, just to establish to see how did that time under tension with the tempo work out for us.
Great, and then supplementing that, we'll be doing a deadlift, mm-hmm. starting our deadlift cycle, and it's almost like an 8 week cycle because it's setting us up for a December deadlift cycle.
Yes.
As the primary lift, so that's cool. So mm-hmm. we'll be working on that. I'm looking forward to that one.
Yeah.
Just because I need work on my deadlift, but I'm gonna hit every day a deadlift that
and
we have.
This is a great time. I mean, we're coming out of the open,
yeah.
you know, which has got a lot of high repetition, and you know, we're gonna take it back to some of the basics of the slower movements where we can focus on maintaining tension throughout our trunk and core, which is the same concept that we're trying to work on.
Yeah, the building strength in the wintertime is awesome. I mean, mm-hmm. it's you're going to be indoors more, mm-hmm. outdoors less, lift the heavy weights, get the strength, and then do the cardio in the springtime.
Yep.
Cool. Well, that's good. And then we're going to our gymnastics skill training. Yep. Is following a little bit of CrossFit's programming, mm-hmm. Which is a focus on the slips.
Yeah,
but I'll let you talk about that.
So the skill for this next cycle, for this skill portion, is going to be also kind of a tailor into our December.
Okay.
So this month we'll be focusing on L-sits, as well as strict pull-ups.
Okay.
So really want to focus on, you know, quality of mechanics, maintaining position, and range of motion, most
right.
importantly, you know, with the yeah. pull-ups, using assistance as you need to, you know, let go of the ego and just focus on good quality range of motion, as well as the L-sit. Now, the L-sit is one of those things that, you know, everybody loves to hate or tends to cherry pick and avoid.
Right.
But what I want to do is encourage you to stick with the L-sit progression, because as we move into our December focus, coming off of all the squats, we're going to be working into a pistol progression.
Okay.
So this is going to have a kind of like a prerequisite build-in to kind of help build up some strength to the trunk, as well as the flexibility.
Yeah. I was at the 10-year affiliate reunion, and Greg Glassman talked about the CrossFit main site's focus on mm-hmm. these things as well. But one of the things he said, you do L-sits. You do a little bit L-sits every day,
mm-hmm.
and everything else you do will get better.
Yeah.
All your lifts, all your gymnastics, everything will get better.
And when you think of it from the deadlift standpoint,
yeah,
you know, what you're doing in the L-sit is you're creating tension through your trunk, right?
Right.
What do you have to do when you set up and brace for a deadlift? You have to be able to pull your ribs down to create that tension. So the L-sit's going to be kind of more of a an accessory component to our strength program.
Oh, that's fantastic. So we've got a good month ahead. We've got some notable workouts and some benchmarks. Girl workout this month, Helen's mm-hmm. on the docket for this month.
Yep.
Fast and Furious. And then I'm looking up on the board, Coughlin. A hero workout this month.
Yeah, so we'll be doing Coughlin on Veterans Day.
Okay, good.
And what that is, we're gonna put a time cap on this one. It's a 6 minute max. The goal is to hold on to the pull-up bar,
right.
dead hang for 6 minutes. But every time you drop off, there's a penalty of an 800 meter run followed with 30 push-ups.
Okay.
So we want to think about using that time in between the hang to let your grip kind of recover, but you know, at the same time, make sure we're maintaining range of motion through push-ups and remember why we're doing it.
Right. Absolutely. Hero workouts are, again, another unique characteristic of a CrossFit affiliate.
Yeah.
And no one else has it.
Yeah.
And for us, it's an awesome way to remember those who died while serving our country.
Mm-hmm.
So that's awesome. The other thing we've got, I noticed we got a Tabata coming up this month,
mm-hmm.
and then our benchmark lifts, got a one rep max in the front squat and one rep max in the push jerk.
Yep. Yeah, so we're testing our front squat at the end. We're not gonna be testing our deadlift at the end of this cycle. We will have kind of like a deload where we're gonna do a bunch of accessory at the end of the month, because then we're gonna bring it back in December. So like you said, it's gonna be like more of like an 8 week cycle from secondary of November to our primary strength for December.
That's great. All of these lifts and benchmarks are on our PRsAllDay calendar
mm-hmm.
that's already published. If you go to our website, PRsAllDay.com and click on the blog. You can find that calendar and see it all mapped out. You can download the PDF and pass it out to your members. We do, and we keep it on display here in the gym so that people can know what to prepare for. Don't skip leg day.
Yeah. Cool. This is how you get strong.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, that's it for this week.
Great. Thanks, guys.
Have fun.